Welcome back to another video in our dashboard series. In this video, you'll explore how to set up the table gadget. You will also gain an understanding of how to analyze and make sense of the data they furnish. How about we begin? The table and KPI gadgets are the sole tools that present real-time information. Unlike other gadgets that retrieve data from the historical database, the table gadget specifically displays real-time data from system devices or hierarchy components in a clear, tabular format. The measurements can be arranged in rows or in columns. Gadget configuration. Let's walk through the process of configuring the gadget. To begin, you can either click on the plus button to add a new dashboard, or access the top menu and select Add a new dashboard. Once the dashboard is named, proceed by clicking on Add Gadget. Next, navigate to the comparison category and select Table. After providing a title for the gadget, such as status table, and choosing the desired level of opacity, proceed to the next step. At this stage, you have the option to customize the font, precision, and color, but for now, let's move on. Measurements. Here you can select the specific measurements you'd like to view from your devices. While it may seem straightforward, it's important to navigate carefully. The tool provides access to over 7,000 measurements, organized across 25 different categories within the PME database. To aid in finding your desired measurement, you can utilize the search box at the top by entering a keyword, or take advantage of the filters within the Show Advanced option. For instance, you can filter the categories by type, such as electricity, and further refine using the Show option. The tool also includes table templates featuring predefined measurements. Once you've identified the measurements you need, simply select them, and they will appear on the right-hand side of the window. Here, you can sort them using the arrows pointing up or down, or remove them from the selection by clicking on the X. It's important to note that you should only select measurements supported by your device. Selecting unsupported variables could result in no readings being displayed. Once you've made your selections, click Next to proceed. Sources section is where you can specify the devices or hierarchy components from which you'd like to retrieve the previously selected measurements. To assist in selecting your sources, you can use the Show Advanced filter located below the search box to filter by type. Once filtered, you can proceed to choose the desired devices. After making your selections, click Next. It's time to configure the layout of your table. Would you like to organize the table by sources or measurements? Depending on your preference, select the appropriate option, and you can preview the layout below. Additionally, you can adjust the width of the table columns. Under Calculations, you have the option to enable statistics for your rows and columns, as well as the ability to add a calculated field. For now, we'll skip this part and come back to it later. Let's click Next. Finally, under Performance, you can select the update interval. It's important to remember that this interval determines how often PME will pull the data from your devices. When dealing with very large tables, it's recommended to enable simple rendering, which removes sorting, styling, and icons, from the table to improve performance in your browser. Click Finish and let's review the results. If we need to make adjustments, we can do so by clicking on the gadget, accessing the top menu. Now that we are here, I realize that I haven't explained the calculations to you yet. Let's delve into it for a moment. The first option, Show Statistics Row, adds a row at the bottom of the table, displaying the aggregated value of each column of data in the table. Select the type of aggregation from the available choices in the drop-down menu to apply to each column of data in the table. Select the highlighting rule from the available choices in the drop-down menu to define a threshold at which the values in the statistics row are highlighted. The threshold values are highlighted in red. The Show Statistics Column option functions similarly to the previous one, but it presents a column to the right of the table. This additional column showcases the aggregated value of each row of data in the table. Enable Highlight Regular Cells to highlight the values in the table as per the highlight rules. Select the highlighting rule from the available choices in the drop-down menu to define a threshold at which the values in the table are highlighted. On selection of under or over, enter the value for the threshold. The threshold values are highlighted in red. Finally, enable Show User-Defined Calculated Field to display a column to the right of the table that displays a calculated value as per the defined mathematical expression. First, enter a label for the column header of the calculated measured column in the calculated field name box. Then enter the expression using the variables of variable reference table in the formula field to calculate the values. Most of the expressions, plus, dash, asterisk, forward slash, percent, caret, min, max, and average, can be used. For example, I am going to calculate apparent power. Looking at the reference table, voltage is variable A, and current is variable B. Therefore, my formula goes A by B. You can activate the highlighting rule for the results as we did with the other features. I hope you found this video enjoyable. See you in our next dashboard video series.